Hello students, welcome to e-tutions. Today we are discussing a topic on a fixed beam on the effect of rotation of one end of a beam. Effect of rotation of one end of a beam. So we are discussing this topic today. In this, if you consider here the effect of rotation of one end of a beam, consider a fixed beam which is fixed at one end and another end is hinged. So for this hinged end, the reaction R, it will be in the downward direction, and there will be a application of moment at the end of the hinged end. Suppose let it be M. And this hinged portion, I am taking it as some B, and the vertical reaction which is present at the fixed end, I am taking it as R. Let L be the center to center distance between these two, and A be the fixed end of the beam. So for this case, what I am doing is, I am considering a beam AB of span L, fixed at A and simply supported at B. And here let the moment at M be applied at the end B, and let R be the reaction at the support B, which is acting downward direction. And here what I am doing is, I am considering a section XX, which is at a distance X from the end B. The section, it is at a distance of X from the end B. Let M suffix X be the section at XX. Then moment at X, that means at section XX, it is equal to minus RX, RX into RX plus M. This will be the moment about the section X. And now we already know that the bending moment about the section X, it is EI into d square y by dx square. So it is equal to moment at section X. This we will get it from the bending moment equation. So what I am doing is, I am equating these two equations. Suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. By equating this equation 1 and 2, I will get it as EI into d square y by dx square equal to minus R into X plus M. So for this, what I am doing is integrating on both sides, with respect to X, that means integral EI into d square y by dx square equal to integral minus R into X into dx plus integral M into dx. So for this, if you apply the integration, you will get it as EI into dy by dx equal to, here it is having minus R into X. So minus R is constant, and X is, integration is applied for this X. So you will get it as minus R X square by 2 plus M is constant. So you will get it as MX, M into X plus C1. This will be the equation you will get it. And at X equal to L, slope dy by dx, its value equal to 0. So what I am doing is, I am substituting this in the above equation. I will get it as 0 equal to ML minus R L square by 2 plus C1. So from this, I am finding out C1 equal to R L square by 2 minus ML. This will be the C1 value. Now for this equation, I am considering this slope equation again, and I am considering this as some equation 3, and again integrating with respect to X on both sides, I will get it as EI into Y equal to MX minus RX square by 2 plus RL square by 2 minus ML. This will be the equation. For this you have to apply the integration for this whole equation, then you will get it. So what I am doing is EI into Y equal to MX square by 2 minus RX cube by 6. That means R by 2 it is constant, integral X square its value is X cube by 3, plus RL square X by 2 minus ML X plus C2. This will be the integration equation. So up to now we have found out the deflection equation, and here what I had to do means at X equal to 0 the deflection, I am taking it as deflection at B. At X equal to L what will happen means the deflection it will be 0. So I am substituting this in the deflection equation. At X equal to L, comma, deflection Y equal to 0. So, and I am substituting this in the above equation in order to find out this C2. And if you consider this C2 value, it will be equal to 0. That means, how it will be equal to 0 means, at X equal to 0, as it is a fixed end, as it is a simply support, at S equal to 0, deflection Y equal to 0. That implies C2 equal to 0. So now I am finding out at X equal to L, what will be the equation. At X equal to L, deflection equal to 0. And I want to find out what will be the equation. Now, what I am doing is, I am undergoing here at X equal to L. At X equal to L, at X equal to L, deflection Y equal to 0. That implies 0 equal to ML square by 2 minus RL cube by 6 plus RL cube by 2 minus ML square. So from this if you derive it, you will get it as M by 2 equal to RL by 3. And if you want to find out R, you will get it as 3M by 2L. This will be the reaction at the simply support. You will get it as R equal to 3M by 2L. And if you substitute this equation at X equal to 0, at X equal to 0, I equal to I suffix B. Now substituting it in the slope equation, I will get it as EI into I suffix B equal to 0 minus 0 plus RL square by 2 minus ML. So in this equation, I am substituting the above values, M equal to 2RL by 3. I will get it as EI into I suffix B equal to 3M by 2L into L square divided by 2 minus ML. So if you solve this, you will get it as EI into I suffix B equal to minus ML. So I is ML by 4. You will get it as minus ML by 4. So in this, if you want I suffix B equal to minus ML by 4 EI, this will be the slope at the end B. You will get it like this. And if you consider the moment, that implies if you want to find out the moment, M equal to minus 4 EI into I suffix B by L. This will be the moment at the end. Now, the bending moment at A, it will be taken as M minus RL. The bending moment at A is M minus RL. It will be equal to M minus 3M by 2L into L. You will get it as it is equal to 2m minus 3m by 2, which will be equal to minus m by 2. So at the fixed end, the moment at the end A, it will be, you will get it as moment at the end A, it will be equal to 2ei I suffix B by L. In order to produce a rotation by I suffix B at support B, the moment required at B, it will be equal to minus 4 EI into I suffix B divided by L. Similarly, the moment induced at A, it will be 2 EI into I suffix B divided by L. So this means in a fixed beam AB carrying a loading, for it the end B loses its fixity and rotates by I suffix B, and the end B it will be reduced by 4 EI I suffix B by L, which we had discussed here, and the end moment at A it is increased by 2 EI I suffix B by L. So this will be the effect of rotation of one end of a beam. Hope students you had understood this concept. Thank you for listening this lecture. Thank you. 5th one.